in London. And then maybe the energy, the chi kept me in the East. So, and thanks to Sylvia to bring me back here today, monkey year, monkey day. So I think it could be the metal energy, which means the West, which brings me back to the Western Europe. So I'm so happy to see many of my former students grow up to be very famous consultants, and I'm happy to come back to talk to you. So today my subject is Formulas of Destiny. So that is actually the most traditional, authentic Chinese fortune telling. So Formulas means your birthday. Everybody has a birthday. So year, month, day, and time. So once you know your birthday, then everything about you is written in your, in like a cosmic code, written in this birthday. So actually, I find this subject very fascinating. I have been teaching and exploring this. It still never failed to amaze me. In the past 20 years, I have seen so many examples. So therefore, when you study this subject, it's actually about yourself. So it's the Chinese called Four Pillars of Destiny, Ming Ni. Ming Ni means the theory of life. So therefore, everybody has a life. So why not we understand it? And I found among all these kind of fortune telling systems, and Four Pillars of Destiny is quite unique, because all you need to know is just to translate your birthday into Chinese characters. And the philosophy is so simple, so beautiful. The beauty of this subject is the foundation is easy to understand. So first thing, we know everything is made up of five elements, metal, wood, fire, water, and earth. Then we are part of the universe, we also make up of five elements. So therefore, how we connect our five elements with the five elements coming from the universe is through the Chinese calendar. So that's one amazing thing, a big mystery in human heritage. We don't know how the Chinese can invent such a calendar, 2700 BC. And this calendar is able to read your fortune. So that's all we need. All you need is we need to know your birthday, and then we translate into Chinese characters, and just based on these eight characters, that's why we call Bazi. Bazi means eight characters. Then you can read everything. Amazing information is written just in eight characters. So therefore, of course, this is a very fascinating subject. The more you study it, the more you admire how clever are the ancient people. We never understand how they can invent such an amazing, accurate system. So therefore, my talk is just like telling stories. If you enjoy telling stories, because we read the story blood of people's lives. So therefore, I have many examples prepared, but of course, in 30 minutes, I can only explain to you maybe one or two famous person. So therefore, I think the most appropriate is somebody very familiar to you. So therefore, I have chosen somebody belong to the royal family. So therefore, the first thing is everything is five elements. So this is this is Chinese calendar. So therefore, this is actually nothing difficult for foreigners, because I teach a lot of foreigners. I even teach in Moscow, Middle East, Istanbul, everywhere. And they have no problem learning this Four Pillars of Destiny. Why? Because all you need to know is just 22 Chinese characters. That's all. But you have to know this 22. 22 is easy. You can spend just one day and put some effort. You can memorize. And they are structured with two kinds of characters. And this is called heavenly stem. A heavenly stem are usually written on top. So that means the energy you receive from heaven, from beyond the earth, coming from above. Then we are people standing on earth. So therefore, below our feet are the earthly branches. So earthly branches means the energy we receive from our mother earth. So therefore, earthly branch is more related to the changing of the four seasons. So that's why we have 12. Heavenly stem actually reflects five elements. So it's just five elements from heaven. They are turning around in the cycle of birth. And then each element has yin and yang. That's why we have 10. Five yang and five yin. That's heavenly step. Then every branch is 12 animals. 12 animals is like Western astrology. So you divide a year into 12 zodiac signs, we divide the year into 12 animals. So they talk about the earth going around the sun in one circle. It goes through 12 months. So that's why 12. So therefore the system is, we put one heavenly stamp on top of one animal. So that's why this year is called Bing Sun. Bing Sun means fire over monkey. So that's how it comes about. So we have this system for year, month, day, and time. Then everybody has your birthday, therefore you already have populace. And once you have populace, you will be amazed to see how much information you can retrieve. So okay, so I mentioned to you, let's use her as an example. Because this is an old case, but still a very classical example of how a person's life is so 100% accurately expressed by means of formulas. So when you learn formulas, the purpose is you find reason behind everything that happened. For example, I just mentioned why I come to the West, because of monkey year, means metal. Monkey day, metal. So the metal brings me to the West. So therefore, everything that happened around you, happened in your life, after you learn populace, you have answer. So that's a very good guidance to you to plan your future, to you how you make decisions about making choice about career, love, everything. Okay, we just tell the story of this, and you see the logic behind how we explain this person's life. So therefore, our four pillars are like this. So you have two characters year, two characters for month, two characters for day, and two characters for hour. So the first thing we look is, each pillar actually represents somebody related to you. So the basic thing is, the year represents your grandfather, grandmother. That the older generation. And the month represents your father and mother, your immediate parents. And the day is yourself, and under you is your spouse. We call this house of spouse, so therefore that's the husband, that's Prince Charles. And the hour means the children, so therefore this water is Prince William. So therefore actually it's not only looking at yourself, looking at the whole family around you. Okay, so then, the focus is on the day. That day is the Yingwood day. That is Lady Diana herself. That's called the Day Master herself. So therefore, all the explanation is based on you are a wood person. So how are you related to the other element in your life? So for example, so we see, okay, if you are wood, then your man, your husband, is the element that conquer you. Because the logic is man conquer woman. So it's not fair, but it is the logic. So therefore, the element that conquer her is her husband. So therefore, we actually see a Prince Charles is here. Now this is metal, representing Prince Charles. And also, these four pillars also represent four stages in your life. And then, it appear in the year means when you are very young. You're already married. Because you have your husband show up, when you are before 20 years old. So we say the first year pillar represents your life before 20 years old. And then the month pillar is about 20 to 35. And the day is after 35. And the hour is old age after 50. So therefore, when you have the main element, this is called the power element. Power element is the man conquering the woman. So therefore, that means the husband show up when she was very young. So actually, she married before 20. Okay, so then not only the husband show up here, but the metal also show up here. That is her luck. So therefore, this is called the four pillars. Four pillars means once you're born, you are composed of these elements. That's your inborn quality. Then after you are born, you have to go through a passage of life. And the passage of life is called your luck. So that's why the Chinese has this famous saying, number one is your destiny, number two is your luck, number three is feng shui, number four is kindness, Number five is education. So this is the five top qualities to make a person successful in life. So therefore, four pillars actually take care of the first two. Number one, destiny. Number two, luck. So therefore, that is her destiny, and that is her luck. Her luck, you can, through your luck, you can trace her ups and downs in life in every age of her life. So each luck pillar, we say, it occupies about 10 years of your life. So therefore, the number on top is the age. So like they are between 2 to 12, the first luck is wood and earth. And then after 12, fire and monkey. Fire monkey, what is monkey? Monkey is metal element. Metal element means the man appear. So therefore, the man already appear before she is 22. So she married actually about 19 years old. So therefore, the man already appear in her luck. So that supports this metal. So the metal marry her. And then her marriage continue into the next luck. The metal is still there. So between 22 to 32, there's still a marriage because the man is still there. Then 32, that is 1993, exactly that year, she divorced because her metal luck finished. Means her relationship with the husband finished at that age. So therefore she is into a new luck, which is birth and earth, which is actually not very good, not good luck. So therefore, how do you know which is good luck, which is bad luck? The logic of four pillars is talking about you have to achieve balance. So when you have balance, you have good luck. When you are out of balance, you are in bad luck. Because we look at this wood is actually quite weak. This wood has very little water to support. You can say the best person in her life may be Prince William, because that's her children. Her children is most close to her. And there's a distance between she and her husband. Why? Because between her and her husband, there's another wood. What is another wood? Another competitor. Another woman. So therefore, actually, she is born like this. There is a distance. Her husband and her is in between. There is a blockage caused by another person. Therefore, we know this person who is. And it's written in her destiny already. So therefore, this wood is actually quite weak because there's only one little water element to support her. And this little water is very much depend on this metal, because according to the cycle of birth, metal supports water, water supports wood. So therefore, actually, this metal is very important. You can imagine if the metal die, the metal goes away, this water has no chance to survive, then she has nothing to support her. And she will also into trouble. So then, now she is into 32. It's an earth luck, very heavy earth. And what is earth do? Earth will destroy water. And if you need water, you don't need earth. So exactly that's why we say, this is very bad luck. So therefore, since she divorced, she actually is into 10 years of bad luck. And bad luck created by earth element. So therefore, if you are in bad luck, there comes a bad year of earth again, then that will be the year of disaster because your bad luck double up. Okay, so therefore, then it comes like in 97. That is a year of ox, and ox is earth. Have you heard about earth penalty? Earth penalty means you have ox, stock, and gold all come together, creating massive amount of earth. So this is ox, this is dog, and this is goat. So therefore, that year, you can already see, she is into great danger. Great danger related to earth. So how she died? She died on the road. And what's the element of the road? Earth. And she died inside a tunnel. What is the element of the tunnel? Earth. And her car crashed against the wall, not crashed against another car. That is again earth. So therefore, exactly on this day, she died in an earth environment. So therefore, everything is just based on the logic of five elements. And then on that day she died, actually you can see how it happened. She is with other people. You can say, this wood is herself, and next to her is Another wood means a friend. Who is this friend? She has a bodyguard. The bodyguard is next to her. And then on that day, there comes another wood. So that is the driver. The driver comes. Therefore, you can count already 1, 2, 3 people. But this, the fourth person is the Egyptian man. It's her boyfriend. And boyfriend is not wood anymore. Boyfriend is metal, because it's somebody who comes to her. So that's why that is now no longer Prince Charles. It is Dodi Al-Fayed. It's the Egyptian man. So therefore, Egyptian man, the bodyguard, herself, the driver, four people involved in the car at that moment of time. And then the clash happened at midnight. Midnight is a fire hour. The fire shows up. The fire, first thing is to kill this metal. So therefore, the Egyptian man died first. So this fire kills the metal. And then, as I explained, this metal is very important. So once this metal passes away, the water cannot survive, because it's in very strong earth. The earth immediately kills the water. So therefore, if the water dies, she has to die, because there's no more support in her life. And what is the cause of her death? Something injury in her lung. She has injury in her lung. And what element is the lung? So the five element also very much used in Chinese medicine. So each organ related to one element. And metal is her lung. So exactly it tells you, this metal died, therefore she died. So therefore, is it exactly explain what happened in her life? So therefore, that is quite amazing aspect of populace of destiny. Actually, this is one of the classic example, but actually I have numerous examples. Okay, so therefore I can explain one more. Of course, he is the person very much involved in this accident. So, who is he? He is a very strong water person. Water, 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 water. And then in the year pillar is an earth element. And earth conquer water. Earth conquer water means power element. And that's the power. Therefore, he is a prince, he's a royalty. Everybody look forward to the throne. This is also the position of the king, the throne. But he has many competitors, because he's not alone. In front of him, his parents, his father and mother, competing with him, keeping the throne, not allowed to give to him. And then also, he is competing with the hour. The hour is Prince William. So therefore, he has so many competitors in life. So that's why that is an obstacle. You cannot, being a king, you cannot share your power with two other people. So therefore, if you are having a birthday like this, so it's very difficult to become king, because being a king, you have to be lonely. Okay, so that's why, that explains why he's still not yet become king. Okay, then now we look at his love life. Interesting thing is, this is the best element in his life, the wood. Because he's strong water, water needs wood, needs fire. He wants to balance his water. So the best element he has is his wife. So therefore he has a very devoted relationship with his wife. So that's why, but if you are his wife, what do you feel? You are not happy because you are surrounded, suffocated with so much water. So you are like a little flower floating in a big ocean of water. So will you feel happy? Just like a child taken care of by so many mothers, so many teachers paying all the attention to one child, will the child feel happy? No. So therefore, you will be in a very difficult position, surrounded by so much restrictions, if you are his wife. Okay, now we look at his populace. So his luck. Actually, he's a very lucky guy. So you can see he is a water person. Being strong water, you need wood, you need fire, you need earth to balance out your water. So then all his luck is good luck. You see, he has a lot of wood, fire, and wood, earth and fire, until now he still have fire. So that was his actually very lucky guy. His whole life is doesn't matter, even though he's not a king, doesn't matter. He still spend good time. Then, how about his marriage, his love? So being a water person, man conquer woman, so he's a man, therefore he conquer fire. Fire is his woman, okay? So therefore you look for fire. There's no fire in his destiny, but he found fire in his luck. So therefore the first fire comes up when he's 28. Yeah. So I don't know why the numbers are a little bit misplaced. So 28 is actually referred to this fire tiger. So therefore this is the first time he meet a lover. He meet a woman. And it's a strong woman because it's a yang fire. Yang usually means older, stronger. And sitting on the tiger, tiger is a very powerful wood, fueling this fire, making the woman older and stronger. But who is this? Definitely not Lady Diana. So at that time, this is Camilla. So therefore, she show up in his life for 10 years. So that means they have very close, influential relationship. But why they don't get married? Because he is number two in line. There is another man in front of him. Because he's water, there's a competitor in front of him. And this pig and this tiger combined, if you know the animal combined, pig and tiger combined means this man already married it to this woman. Okay, so therefore they had a very strong relationship, but no chance to get married. Therefore he wait until 28, and another fire show up. And this is a yin fire. Yin fire is a younger, more sweet, more gentle, more female kind of woman. Okay, this is sure, this is Lady Diana. So therefore, 28, he found Lady Diana, and they get married. Very simple, this woman can marry because this woman sits on the rabbit, and the rabbit is excelling in his house of spouse. So therefore, this woman is very much into his family. So therefore, they have a marriage for this 10 years. But this marriage lasts until 38. When he comes into the earth luck, no more fire, no more woman. Because when he's 38, Lady Diana died in the car accident. So therefore, this 10 years, he has no woman at all. 38 to 48, so when he is in the earth luck, he has no woman at all. Then, when he's 58, the fire returns. Okay? So, but this is the fire underneath means, yes, he has a woman, but not as high profile as the previous relationship, because it's underneath, it's a little bit low profile. Okay? So, therefore, this is the time he marry again. And then the marriage continued until now, because the fire is still in his life. So, therefore, again, is it accurate? You know more than me, this kind of story, but it's 100% accurately reflected in populace. So that's why when we have the birth year, time, month, and day of a person, you can trace your life history. And the positive thing is, it gives you chance to prepare. So you can foresee what's going to happen in the next life. If it is good luck, you can plan to maximize its usage, make good choice what direction the formula is telling you to go, and make the most out of it. But if it's bad luck, you can prepare. So therefore, formulas can use as a preventive measure, particularly in protecting your money and health. So when you talk about health, we can, in the formulas, we see the principle is, when the elements are not in balance, you get sick. So therefore, you can foresee this imbalance long before it happens. So therefore, today you have health supplements. You can replenish the necessary health supplements to balance your elements. And this is actually a preventive, the most effective preventive way to protect your health. Because why? Because most of the people, when you get sick, you go to see a doctor. But the doctor can only see you when you are sick. So what happens before, what is the basic structure of the element in your body? The doctor don't know. Because when he examines you, you're already sick. you're already out of balance. But the four pillars is the only information you get once you're born. Once you're born, you already can foresee at what time you will have what kind of sickness coming up, and then you can make, you have plenty of time to make preparation to prevent that kind of sickness. And also you talk about money luck, your career direction. So many clients come to us, so their son like to be a singer. He seems to be very talented, like singing and dancing, but he's only like 10 years old. So therefore they don't know in the future can he be really a movie star or singer develop in that direction. Of course, only the four pillars can tell. If in the future he shows a lot of money, he is a businessman. So therefore the singing and dancing is only a temporary kind of hobby. So therefore that is actually a very fascinating subject, particularly if you are a feng shui consultant. Because we always emphasize, when you do feng shui, it's not to make the house happy. What's the point of making the house happy? It's to make the people inside the house happy. So when you want to make the people inside the house of happy, you will feel very much handicapped if you don't understand your client's fortune. So therefore, there are a lot of things you can integrate four pillars with your feng shui skill. For example, we use four pillars to recommend suitable color, suitable decorative objects, and we use four pillars to tell about which room is more suitable for this person, which room is more suitable for that person. We even use four pillars to cross-check whether your feng shui measurement is correct or not. Because our experience is, most of the feng shui, if you are living in a good house, good feng shui house, usually your four pillars means you are in good luck. If they doesn't match, means you may have to recheck your measurement. Maybe you have measured a little bit wrong about the direction, maybe you have to use the wrong gauge. So therefore, that is also a very essential skill. So that's why my training program, I found it very effective because I have been doing this for 20 years, and it has produced many famous consultants and a very respectful kind of feng shui experts now. And my training program includes four pillars as one of the most important subjects. So therefore I teach feng shui as well as four pillars as well as eating. So therefore, four pillars, there are actually too many things to tell. So I remember, we may as well mention him also, because he is related to the first two examples. Okay, so then, a lot of people compare Kate Middleton with Lady Diana. So how will be the marriage life of Kate Middleton? Why Lady Diana's marriage is on the rocks? Why, then how is Kate Middleton different? So you take a look at Lady Diana. She is basically very intelligent woman because she is born in the month of fire. So what is fire? Fire is your something you create. The element created by wood is fire. Fire means intelligence. But intelligence means you don't want to be supervised. Intelligence means you want freedom. You want to be doing something by yourself without any restriction of discipline and rules and regulations. So therefore, she was born like this. She is a free soul. She doesn't like any restrictions because she is born in a fire month. And intelligence in the negative sense, it means what? If a child is very intelligent, you can say he is very clever. But you can also say he's very naughty. So she was naughty. That means she is rebellious. She's aggressive. So that kind of lady is not suitable to be in a royal family because she is under too much restrictions. So another factor is, we look at the day pillar, which shows the relationship with the husband. And this is called the house of spouse. House of spouse, unfortunately, was inborn. Once you're born on this day, you know you have something wrong in your marriage. Why? Because that is her unfavorable element. Because we say Earth is unfavorable, and exactly the house of spouse is Earth element. So therefore, whenever if you have a house of spouse like this, unfortunately, whoever she marries, she don't feel happy. Because that is her unfavorable element. It's the element she don't need. And the relationship is she want to control her husband. Because her husband is Earth, she's wood. Wood by nature controls Earth. But how can she control? Her wood is so weak, and the Earth is so powerful. Earth is supported by fire, earth. So therefore, of course, she cannot fulfill this kind of desire. So that's why she's also not happy in life. And of course, she has a competitor. So, okay, so that is the case of Lady Diana. Now you understand how she is not suitable as a princess. But now, when we look at Kay Middleton, exactly the opposite. So she is a water lady, and Prince William is a wood person, and wood needs water. And this wood is weak because he has a lot of fire, a lot of earth. There's only one water supporting him. And what is this water? His wife. So therefore, his best element is his wife, which is water element. And therefore, he chose to marry a strong water lady. And this lady is full of water, a lot of metal, only in winter, supporting the water. So therefore, this exactly meets his need. And then, okay, now, do you see any wood element here? No wood element? So what does wood element mean? Wood element means your intelligence. So it doesn't mean she is not intelligent, it means she is not rebellious. She doesn't rebel against any rules and regulations. And she sits on Earth. Earth is control. Earth is her power element. Earth conquer water. So therefore, she let her husband conquer her, control her. And she never rebel. She never have any wood element to rebel against her husband. So therefore, that kind of lady is the best, most suitable being in the royal family. Because she is very careful, very knowledgeable. Metal is resources element. Resources element means you're educated, you're careful, you think, but you do not need to do. You only think. Therefore, careful, planning, conservative kind of woman. And then she needs wood and fire because she's strong water. So therefore, he has a lot of wood and fire. So therefore, they are a good match. They are with what we call compatibility. Compatible means you have the favorable element for your husband, and the husband has the favorable element for you. And if two people like this, definitely they attract each other for a long, long time. Okay, so therefore, he looks like the future king. So I don't have to tell you, you all know. He looks like. And his power element comes, this is metal. Metal is power element. Power element comes from 35 onward, it shows up. So therefore, we're here. How old is he now? 33, yeah. So therefore, it will be quite near future. He show up very strong power. Show up very strong power means he show his status as a king. And you can see he's suitable because he is single. He's not like his father. His father has so many competitors. And he has no competition. He's alone. He's the only one. So this is most suitable to be. The only position is for the king. Okay, time's up. Okay.